What's up, everyone? My name's Andrew, and I wanted to welcome you to our online experience here at Christ Church. If we haven't had a chance to meet before, I'm part of our team at our Hilltop campus, and I just wanted to say how thankful I am to get to spend a part of today with you. And hey, special shout out to those of you who are checking out Church Online with us for the first time. It means a lot that you're here, and I hope that you find this to be a meaningful experience. If you've never been to a service at Christ Church before, I think what you're going to experience today is a pretty accurate picture of who we are. And we'd love to see you sometime at our East or Hilltop campuses for one of our 9:30 or 11 a.m. services some Sunday soon. Well, hey, before we kick things off today, I just wanted to mention that we'd love to know that you're with us. So if you would, join us in the chat during the service as we're hanging out together this morning. I'd love to know where you're watching from. So here's the deal. Let us know in the chat where you're tuning in from. And for whoever is watching from the most unique spot, I'm going to send you a Starbucks gift card. Sound good? Just comment, watching from the couch, or watching from the deer blind, or watching on my way home from the beach. Whoever's got the best answer is going to get some Starbucks on us. Okay, well, again, we're super glad you're a part of this morning with us. We're going to join in some worship as our East Campus team leads us in. So let's get ready and experience worship together. idea of a new year always comes with the potential of starting something new and fresh. Starting a new habit, a new routine, or even just a new mindset can do something amazing to transform the trajectory of your life. Here at Christ Church, we've been experiencing all sorts of new things. New seasons of ministry, a new lead pastor, new campuses. Even this week, we started something new as we begin our new service times of 9:30 and 11 a.m. for all our campuses. And you know what? When we take a step of faith into the unknown to do something new, oftentimes that is right where God meets us, shaping us and molding our faith to make us stronger and more like Jesus. I don't know what steps of faith you're contemplating in this new year. Maybe you don't even know yet yourself. But I believe that God is already anticipating your needs and ready to help you as you take your next step toward Him. And that's exactly what our lead pastor, Zach Bayless, is going to share about with us today as we take a look at what it means to keep taking next steps toward Jesus. So let's get ready and join Zach as he shares with us about what transformation in Jesus looks like.
Well, hey, I'm excited for this message that I get to share with you, but first I want to take just a quick moment and pause, and I want to invite each and every one of you to go ahead and sign up on our app or our website, or if you're on our online platform, you can use the chats window to sign up with us and join us for 21 days of prayer and fasting. It's going to launch January 7th, right when we get back. We're going to kick off into that time. And so we're intentionally setting some things aside, things that push us and challenge us so that we can focus on our relationship with Christ, dial in and kick off our year the best way possible. And so I want to invite all of you to go and sign up for that so that we can know that you're participating and join in with us for an incredible 21 days of prayer and fasting. With that, let's go ahead and jump into the message. I think most of us always take advantage of a brand new year to start with some new goals in mind, some new habits that we want to shift or change, or maybe a resolution or something like that. And for most of us, it is also not uncommon for us to fast forward a couple months and find ourselves off the wagon or falling down or trying to figure out how to restart again. We're kind of used to this pattern. And I think as people of the world, in truth, it takes pure determination and try hard to get anything accomplished. And even our abilities are so limited in our own flesh, and we often fall off the wagon too easily. However, as Christ followers, as Christ people, we have access to something different that is so radically different than what the world has. We have access to someone who is radically different than what a lost and broken world really has. And I want to talk about one of my favorite words this morning in our message, and it's transformation. It's a word that means a great deal to me. Have you ever watched any of those extreme home makeover shows where they'll have this massive crew come in? It starts with this house that's, in truth, a complete wreck. It's an absolute mess. It needs gutted. It needs redone almost in every single way. And then in the span of this hour-long episode, they take what would have been this complete dump of a house and what would have taken weeks to finish, and they jam-pack it all in this minutes-long episode, you know, maybe an hour-long episode. And we love it. We get to see this complete transformation in such a short amount of time. We see the walls removed, new lights being added, and new flooring. We see work to the foundation. All these big projects all happens in this short time. And there's always a room, of course, that Ty Pennington blocks off from everybody. This is his little special project. You don't get to see it until it's done. And there's always this same process that happens. And then the moment that we all love is when the family gets to come home and they see their house for the first time. And it's this like big shocking moment. They see all the things that were done and they see this complete transformation. They were gone And they came back and it's a totally different place. And it almost feels instantaneous. Now, what we don't like to be a part of at all is an unfinished project, an unfinished transformation project. We love seeing before and after pictures, but before pictures when there's nothing after it is not very inspiring. We don't love that at all. We don't like that feeling. We just want to see, what does it look like when it's finished? What does it look like when it's done? We love completed transformation stories, but it leaves us in an uncomfortable place when things are untransformed and undone and not finished. Most of us don't have a massive joy for the journey that it takes us to get to the place of transformation that maybe we desire. I always want results as soon as possible. Maybe you're a lot like me, but we always want these results as soon as we possibly can. And we see in Scripture that for all of us who are followers of Jesus, we're called to an entire lifelong journey of transformation. That sounds like a long time. It's an entire lifelong journey of transformation that each one of us is called to. This transformation is never truly complete within us until we come face to face with God at the end of our physical life. Now, I don't know about you, but as someone who likes to see all the results as quick as possible, I find this so challenging to think about. But there are two different levels of transformation that we experience. One of them is an immediate promise of transformation that we're given. But this other is a journey that we walk for a lifetime. We see the Apostle Paul in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. He tells us this. He's talking about a transformation of our identity. And he says in verse 17, he says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come." This is an immediate gift that we're given in our identity. This is kind of that move that bus moment that we get to experience. We see one thing one way, and then we have access to a completely new thing in an instant. However, I think for many of us, it can be tough to look around and we still see all of the mess around us. We see that we still feel like a mess in a lot of ways. I remember the moment as a younger kid when I gave my life to Jesus. I was excited about it. I meant it. It was a sincere and true moment for me, but I immediately looked around and I was so intimidated because I didn't have this figured out like it seemed like other people did. I felt like I was too far behind and it wasn't going to be possible for me to catch up. Let's be honest, I still don't have all this figured out, but the truest challenge of transformation is that each one of us is just simply called to learn as we go. We don't have to start at a certain place past our own willingness to say, "I'm in." We don't always like that, however. This new creation that we're given is the one that allows us to point to the old self and say, "That's not who I am anymore. I'm not that guy anymore. I'm no longer defined by all of the things that I've done wrong in my life. I'm no longer defined by my mistakes. It's no longer who I am. I'm now worth more." And at this place, this is God claiming us as His own. This is Him speaking to the transformation of our identity that we're given. And it's final. We have to walk our own journeys of receiving that, but it's been spoken over you already. And it's something that's completely offered to us from day one when we choose to follow Jesus. As soon as we made the decision to follow Jesus, it was us recognizing that we wanted to step into a new path, a new plan for our lives. No longer the one that we have, but now the one that He has for us. It's the truest heart of transformation, wanting what God has for us rather than what I just want for myself, or maybe what I've always wanted for myself. It's surrendering that for a different plan. It's what God has for us. If we stay in 2 Corinthians and flip back to chapter 3, we see what happens in this moment as we receive Christ. So I want to read this starting in verse 16, it says this, "But when one turns to the Lord, the veil is removed." So I want to pause here. This means from day one, since we gave our life to Christ, if you've made this decision, from day one, you have been granted and given immediate access to God. And it's through the power and gifting of the Holy Spirit. We have the gift of the Spirit now living within us. We've begun what is truly a personal and a transformational relationship with Christ. And He's now dwelling in our hearts. So let's keep reading in verse 17. "Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And we all, with unveiled face, beholding the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another. For this comes from the Lord, who is the Spirit." So there's a few really important things that we see here that I think we need to hold on to. First, we see that we have this offering of freedom it's been given to us already. And because of the relationship that we all have in Christ, we have access to behold the glory of the Lord. Okay, so what does that mean, to behold the glory of the Lord? Well, we do that by beginning to be transformed into the very same image of God from one degree of glory to another. Other versions say from glory to glory. And it says that all of this is done by the Lord, who is the Spirit. It's the Holy Spirit at work in us that leads us to this transformation. Now, I want to help and give us a definition of transformation now with all of this set up in mind. But it's this. Transformation is the power of the Holy Spirit in your heart, working in your heart, leading you to take a next step. Transformation is the power of the Holy Spirit working in your heart, leading you to take a next step. I think transformation is one of those things that's so challenging for us, because oftentimes we feel as if we aren't making any progress at all. It's too slow. It's taking too long. I'm not doing good enough. And we feel like that because most of us remember pretty well who our old self was. And to be honest, most of us, we still struggle with old thoughts and old habits and old self things. We still experience this and we still mess up. And it's like, I just don't think I'm doing very well at this whole following Jesus thing. I still have problems. Maybe you've felt this. When we look at other people and that doesn't help at all. We certainly, when we look at Jesus and when we think, dang, I'm not even close. I mean, I'm not near close enough to doing this very well at all. But I think one of the most important questions for us to answer is, are we committed to it though? Are you committed to it? Because transformation is a personal journey. It's a personal journey that each one of us are on. It doesn't matter where someone else is on their journey. What matters is, are they on their journey and are you on your journey? If we're committed to it, then it's just not about the rate at which we are transformed. It's all about our willingness to just continually surrender one single thing at a time as the Holy Spirit brings it to our heart to press into, to lean into. Paul tells the church in Ephesus that he prays that the eyes of their hearts would be opened or enlightened so that we would all experience and understand the true hope that God has called us to, which is the riches of His glorious inheritance in Christ Jesus. And one of my all-time favorite promises in all of Scripture is the promise that the Apostle Paul makes to us in Philippians chapter 1. He says this in Philippians chapter 1, verse 6, "And I'm sure of this, and I'm sure of this, that He who began a good work in you will bring it to completion at the day of Jesus Christ." I don't know about you, but I find so much hope in this promise. Because like I said, for me, the God who began a good work within me says that He promises that He will see it to completion. He promises it doesn't matter the mistakes that I may make in the meantime, as I continually fall and I walk this journey of transformation, I have a promise. We've talked about this in our Grounded series. I have a promise that I can place my full weight on. That's what we get with these promises of God. And he says, the work that I began in you, I'm going to complete it. I promise you that. And so we have this thing that we can believe in and stand on, that God will finish to completion what he started in each one of you. God's work for us began when Christ died on the cross in our place. And then his work within us began when we first chose to make a decision to believe in him and to offer him ourselves to him. And now the Holy Spirit lives within each one of us, enabling us in this journey of transformation to be more like Christ every single day. This is the journey that you and I, as followers of Jesus, face. Even though you may find it overwhelming like I do at sometimes, we're called to be imitators of Christ and image bearers and a transformed people. That sounds like a lot, and it sounds like more than we can do in our own strength, and it is. But this is why we've been given these gifts, these helps to lead us along the way. And so I want to encourage all of you with this. In your journey of transformation in Christ, friends, you are not alone. You are not alone. We've been given the gift of the Holy Spirit, and so you're not alone, but we've also been given the gift of each other, the gift of community and church people and believers and followers of Christ that are walking this same journey out at the same time as all of us are. And so you are not alone. The reality is we all have God's truth. We have his word, and it tells us everything that we need to know. But I know from personal experience that sometimes we need our friends and the people walking and journey along with us to remind us of what God's word really says sometimes. And so I'll start. I'll go first. My name's Zach, and I'm your friend. And I want to remind you that in God's word, in Proverbs 27, it says, iron sharpens iron, and one man sharpens another. The truth is, we are called to do this together. You'll never be successful walking this journey alone. You were never intended to walk this journey alone. We're supposed to do it together in community, life on life with each other. One of the things that the Lord has really placed on my heart for Christ Church is that we would begin to experience the abundance that God has for us. That word has been just coming up time and time again over the last month or so. I just believe God has so much more for us than we have ever experienced in him. But the reality is, it's going to take a faithful walk of obedience in our journeys of transformation to ever begin to experience it. It's going to require us to say yes to what he has for us. And the truth is, some of us have been following Jesus for years, but you're in the same place today as you were 5 years ago, because you're just doing the same thing over and over again, as if something may magically change for you. And I know from personal experience at seasons of my life, it doesn't work. We're prompted to take intentional next steps in our journey, but if we don't take those, we will find ourselves stuck, oftentimes not just sitting idle, but moving backwards, further away from the place that we're ultimately called to go. And so it's probably fair to say most all of us, we love the idea of being more like Christ and being transformed. When it comes to walking that journey, we start to feel like it's too much, or it's too big, or it's impossible. We don't see how it's possible. And so I want to ask and answer this question. How is it that I can take an intentional next step? For each of us, we need to ask and answer this question. How can I take an intentional next step? Well, at the risk of feeling like a horrible oversimplification, the truth is this: you just have to start somewhere. You just have to start somewhere. The reality is we're all in this same journeys, and we find ourselves at radically different places than each other. And I love that. I love that that's how the church is made up. But this is one of the significant reasons why I wanted to start taking a specific next step every single week that we gather together. If you want to talk about practical transformation, this is exactly it. Every single time that we gather as a body of Christ, we walk away after we engage God's Word, we have an intentional next step for each of us to take. It may be a next step in an action that we are called to do in that upcoming week. It may be a passage of Scripture that we're to read and reread and pray on. It may be a big question for us to ponder and reconcile in our hearts. But each one of them are always designed to activate something within us after we read and engage with God's Word. I've said this so many times, but we can know all of the words in our Bibles, and we can memorize it from cover to cover, but becoming a scholar doesn't help us in our journey of transformation. The transformation is about us becoming more like Christ, not simply knowing more. Everything in here is life-changing if we'll engage it, not just know it in our heads. It has to make that journey down to our hearts. That's where transformation actually starts to happen. And again, we all are in different places in our faith journeys, but I promise you this: if you will take every next step that we give, every next step that we take when we gather together, you will look back at the end of this upcoming year and you'll see a completely and radically transformed person. You will not be the person that you were at the beginning of the year. And I can promise you that because I have experienced this in my own journey, just simply by taking the next steps that we have. It may feel slow as you're moving, because I know how that feels. I know exactly what that feels like, but I promise you that you won't recognize who you are today from the person that you were before you had a relationship with Christ. Pastor and author Eugene Peterson, he describes the journey of following Christ like this. He says, it's a long obedience in a single direction. A long obedience in a single direction. I love how simple he says that. It doesn't make it easy, but it's very simple. It's just simply a long obedience in a single direction. Just us saying yes to the power and the leading of the Holy Spirit working in our hearts, leading us to take a single next step at a time. I have a stack of these. These are our next step cards. And this stack of next step cards, these are my personal ones, and they sit on my desk. And I just keep adding one more every week to the stack as we move on and we begin taking our next steps. And I can tell you that I have been transformed over the last year because of these next steps. And if you'll do the same, I promise you'll experience transformation in your journey following Christ. Well, I want to leave us with one more next step before we enter into a brand new year, and as we bow tie 2023 very well, I want to leave us with one very significant and important next step for us to consider and take. And it's this: what is one spiritual discipline? What is one spiritual discipline that you will engage in throughout this next year? And I'll clarify this so that that doesn't seem more intense than it should to you. What is one thing that you can start doing, big or small? It doesn't have to be big, and so don't overthink this, but what is one simple thing that you can start doing in your spiritual journey, big or small? Because this is what transformation starts with. Maybe you need to just simply make a commitment that I'm going to be at church on Sundays. Maybe that's a big step for you to take. Maybe you want to join and kick off your year with 21 days of prayer and fasting, and you want to pray every day to have an intentional moment every single day that you pray. Maybe that's your next step. Maybe you want to get in a life group for the very first time and you're going to commit to saying yes to that. Maybe you're going to lead a life group. I don't know what your next step may be, but what's one thing that you can commit yourselves to? Maybe it's inviting somebody to church, becoming more bold and vocal about all that God has done in your own personal journey of transformation, inviting others to experience that. There's one of my all-time favorite quotes from a book called Soul Keeping, and it says this: habits will eat your willpower for breakfast. Habits will eat your willpower for breakfast. The truth is, you can want transformation, but wanting it isn't enough. As you look ahead and as we dive into this new year, this next year, I want to invite you to join me on this transformational journey of radically following after Jesus and just simply saying yes to every next step that He invites us and leads us to take. And so I very much hope that you will join me in this next year on this journey of intentionally following after Christ. I want to pray for us as we continue on. Father God, I thank you for your word, and I thank you for this year. I thank you for all that you have done, the journeys that you have led us on. What we have been able to experience in you is only because of you. And Lord, I pray that as we continue on into a new year and a new season, that you would continually do a new thing within us. That you would begin a new part of our transformational journey, that we would take on your image, that we would be bearers of your image. And I pray that in our own lives, you would receive all of the glory that is due your name. Holy Spirit, lead us at every single next step that we take. And we offer ourselves to you. And we pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen. Blessed assurance, 'cause Jesus is mine. He's been my shield and my defender time after time. I'm born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. So I trust in God, my Savior, the one who will never fail. He will never fail. I trust in God, my Savior.
saw the love, and he heard, and he answered. I saw the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. I saw the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. That's why I trust him. That's why I trust him. I saw the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. I saw the Lord, and he heard, and he answered.
What a great reminder of what trusting in Jesus looks like. Every step of obedience and every step of faith can lead us into deeper relationship with Him. Remember, a life with Jesus isn't about being perfect. It's simply all about taking one step at a time as we are led by the Holy Spirit on our journey of becoming more like Him. And I want to encourage you to take action on the next step Zach gave us. What's one thing that you can put into practice in this next year to take an intentional next step closer to Jesus? Whatever that thing is, write it down, tell a friend, put it on your phone. Whatever it takes to be intentional about taking a step this year in your faith journey. And I pray you'll see God show up in ways you never dreamed possible. Well, before we wrap things up, I wanted to take a moment to say thanks again for spending a part of your day with us. If you have any prayer requests that you'd like for us to be praying for, you can always go to christpeople.church/prayer and let us know how to be praying for you. And speaking of our website, if you want to help support the mission of Christ Church, you can visit christpeople.church/give and give online through our easy and secure online giving platform. Well, again, it's been great being with you, and I hope that you'll join us in person at our East or Hilltop campuses here in Wichita for one of our services at our new times on Sundays at 9:30 or 11 a.m. We hope you have an amazing new year, and we'll see you all next week.